Yes, a very good morning. Right, so some problem coming in the encoding wherein I am not able to record the, you take it on the live stream on YouTube. So that is why I thought I will record the video today and then I will upload it on the YouTube channel. Okay, right, so today our discussion is going to be about the multiple choice questions, right, the MCQs. I've already told you that you go through the MCQs, right, which are there in series 1 to 9 on the YouTube channel. And in addition to that, in August 19, when ICAI came up with the new module, okay, after each chapter also now they have put a few MCQs. Right, so the August 19 module of ICAI, you can go to the Board of Studies knowledge portal and from there you can download that module. Right, there after each chapter where there are a few MCQs, some 5-6 MCQs given over there, right, those are the ones which we are going to discuss today. Right, so this right now in front of me is the chapter number 1 as per the ICAI module, and in that we have the multiple choice questions. Right, let us look into it. Right, MCQs is a matter of practice. As I've told previously also, you have to develop the knack. Right, you have to get better and better in it. Your guessing skills, your elimination skills, they have to improve, and even your confidence. You know, because every time you select B, you think it should be C. Every time you select C, then you think, oh no, B was only right. And say the fact is that A is right, but you are fighting between B and C. Right, that is always a possibility. Right, so let's go into the questions over here. PMP Limited is an associate company of PMP Inc. Right, a company based in Kuwait. PMP Limited is listed in India, having its corporate office at Assam. The company's operations have remained stable over the years and the management is looking to expand the operations, for which the management is considering different business ventures. The company's auditors issued clean audit report on the financial statements for 2018. For the financial year 2019, the auditors made some changes in their audit team. While the audit partner remained the same, the field in charge has been replaced by the field in charge who was engaged in the audit of the financial statements for 2018 has left the firm. The audit team has a new person as an external quality control reviewer who has specialized in the industry in which the company is operating. Okay, so a lot of facts of the case we get to read over here. EQCR Limited has been employed with the firm for over 2.5 years and yet to clear his CA final exams. Oh, the EQCR fellow, has he cleared his CA final exam? No, he has not yet cleared his CA final exam. Okay, so what are the qualifications for the EQCR? It has to be a chartered accountant, right? Partner of the firm or an employee or a suitably qualified external person. That is mainly for the sole practitioner or the small firms. Right, here what does it say? He is yet to clear the CA final exam. The changes were made on the basis of the consideration that the firm has enough experience of engagement with this client. The audit team commenced the work for the audit for the year ended 2019 after detailed planning, and it was observed that EQCR had various comments on certain matters which were not accepted by the audit partner. Oh, so final level student has so many queries of EQCR. Audit partner had better understanding of the client and after assessing the comments of the EQCR did not find those relevant. The audit partner, without concurrence of the EQCR, finalized the audit and issued the audit report, right? So did he consider the findings of the EQCR, the audit engagement partner? No. So this particular MCQ is from SQC 1 and SA 220. Right, SQC 1, the quality control for firms that perform audits and reviews of historical financial information and other assurance and related services engagement. Right, in the given situation, please advise which one of the following is correct. The changes in the audit team were not appropriate except for the field in charge who had left the firm. EQCR should have been a member of the institute. Okay, seems to be a shortlisted one. The audit partner did the right thing by ignoring the comments of the EQCR, as he is the final authority to decide on any matter and take decisions. Further, EQCR was a junior to the audit partner, but you cannot ignore the comments of the EQCR. This is not a good advice. The audit partner must discuss each and every comment of EQCR with the client and ensure that a proper disclosure in respect of these points should be made either in the financial statements or the audit report. No. It is an internal process for doing an audit. So there is no need to discuss each and every point with the client. EQCR had sufficient and appropriate experience, so he should have been given the authority to objectively evaluate various matters before the report is issued, the significant judgments the engagement team made, and the conclusions they reached in formulating the report. Okay, so that's the definition of EQCR. By ignoring the comments of the EQCR, audit partner took additional professional responsibility on himself. By considering the comments of EQCR, he could have passed on the responsibility to the EQCR. No, ultimate responsibility is going to be of the engagement partner only. Just because you considered his comments, it does not transfer the responsibility to the EQCR. Right? So he could have passed on the responsibility. We don't agree with this point. Right, so what is our final check over here? It is going to be A. Right, the changes in the audit team were not appropriate except for the field in charge who had left the firm, so you have no option. And EQCR should have been a member of the institute. Okay, right, next question. VKPL and Associates, a firm of chartered accountants, have been operating for the last 5 years, says having its office in Gurgaon. The firm has a staff of around 25 persons with 3 partners. The firm has been offering statutory audit, risk advisory and tax services to its various clients. The major work of the firm is for taxation services. The audit partners also discussed that the firm needs to work significantly to improve the quality of services they offer and that they would also help the firm to grow its business. Considering this objective, the firm started training programs for the staff which were made mandatory to be attended. What story? Okay. During one of the training programs on quality, a topic was discussed regarding the information that should be obtained by the firm before accepting an engagement with a new client, when deciding whether to continue an existing engagement, and when considering acceptance of a new engagement with an existing client. So this is very good. This will help you in writing your case studies also, the more and more you read such content. It was explained that the following points may assist the engagement partner in determining whether the conclusions reached regarding the acceptance and continuance of client relationship and audit engagement are appropriate, right? The following points. What are the points? The integrity of the principal owners, key management, TCWG of the entity. The qualifications of all the employees of the entity. Qualification of all the employees, okay. Whether the engagement team is competent to perform the audit engagement and has the necessary capability, including time and resources, right? Considerations while accepting the engagement, SQC1, we talk about Lee Hem, right? Here they are talking about the A over there, the acceptance, continuance of the client relationship. What are the points you need to consider? Right, so client integrity, yes. Qualification of all the employees of the entity, no, not a factor while accepting, that we may check while doing the KOC, and not of all the employees of whom we require during the course while checking the financial statements. Right, pay attention everyone. Right, whether the engagement team is competent to perform the audit engagement and has the necessary capabilities, including time and resources. So this point we call it as the CCTR, no, the competence, capability, time and resources to perform the engagement. The remuneration offered by the entity to its various consultants. Now, why remuneration offered to various consultants need to be considered while accepting continuing client relationship? No. Whether the engage firm and the engagement team can comply with the relevant ethical requirements. Okay, so ethical requirements including independence goes without saying before accepting continuing a client relationship. And significant matters that have arisen during the current or previous audit engagement and their implications for continuing the relationship. Right, so significant matters identified during any previous engagement. Right, so according to me, 1, 3, 5 and 6. Right, so first option is what? 1, 2, 4, 5. Right, so 1, 2, 4, 5, they are saying don't check the engagement team whether it's the CCTR. So obviously this point cannot be valid. Right, next one, what they are saying? 2, 4, 5 and 6. Right, 2, 4, 5 and 6. So they say don't check the integrity of the client. Not done. Integrity certainly we want to check. Next one again, 3, 4, 5, 6. So they are saying don't check integrity. Integrity we want to check. First thing. Right, so the final option that remains for us is D. Right, 1, 3, 5 and 6. Everybody with me? Right, very important. Pay attention. Right, MCQs, very scoring. Even though if you manage to get like, you know, say 15 to 20 marks in the MCQ, right, 30 marks of MCQ, no? Or are you targeting 30 out of 30? Superman type, 30 out of 30 in MCQ. If that happens, nothing like it. But, you know, reality sometimes could also be different. Okay, so 15 to 20 out of 30, 17, 18, 20, like on a realistic basis. So when you get the 20 marks from the MCQ, the remaining 20 you need to get it from the theory part of the paper. Sounds very easy and simple, but it is not so. Okay, right, coming to question number 3. Pay attention, everyone. Zoff is a private limited company engaged in the business of mining. So you'll see all possible types of business being discussed over here. The company's operations are fairly large and its turnover is INR 4,000 crore on an annual basis. Due to the nature of the business and the size of the company has appointed a firm, right, of chartered accountants as its statutory auditor who have the relevant experience of the industry in which the company has been operating. During the course of the audit team had various observations which resulted in many adjustments in the financial statements of the company and was also appreciated by the CFO of the company. Are you following the sentence? Right, don't do over analysis of the sentence also because we don't have to do the PhD. Finally, we have to have so much understanding of the question only how much is in the context of the options which are there and the correct answer which we need to select. Many of the data given in the question is irrelevant also, but we have to scan through it once. Only then we'll come to know what is relevant and irrelevant. Okay. At the time of final reviews of the audit for team, the audit partner requested working paper on the final analytical procedures for the engagement team from the engagement team. However, the engagement team explained that they have performed substantive testing procedures, which also resulted in some adjustments, and the same was incorporated in the final set of financial statements given to the audit partner for the review. And accordingly, there was no need to perform the final analytical procedures. Near the end of the audit, they are saying no need to perform the analytical procedures. And now essay 520, analytical procedures. It talks about analytical procedures at the substantive procedure stage and also at the conclusion stage near the end of the audit. Audit partner was not convinced with this and requested the engagement team to perform this procedure. Considering that the timeline to conclude the audit was approaching, the audit partner also requested the CFO that the audit team would need some more time to perform the final analytical procedures. CFO was very impressed with the engagement team and agreed for the time, but he also told the audit partner that the work of the team was excellent and hence the audit partner should avoid these additional procedures. Right, so the crux of the question is what? Okay, there is no need to perform the final analytical procedures. You are requested to give your view in respect of the matter as per SA 520. Whenever you study the MCQs, pay attention everyone, look over here. Right, whenever you study MCQs, you always have to maintain the discipline of reading the question, reading the four possible options over there, eliminating the three wrong options, concluding according to you which should be the correct answer, and then after that checking with the reference guide of the correct answer, the correct answer given to you. If you already look at the answer and then you study a question, I am telling you, you're wasting your time. Right, in doing studies of MCQ, because anyways you are not developing your knack, you are not applying your own thinking skills. Once you already know the answer, you only keep on convincing yourself ke why this is the correct answer. Right, so that importance is of that discipline is of utmost importance when you study the MCQs. Right, so what is the matter over here? That final stage analytical procedures not required, but audit partner says no, it is required. Right, you are requested to give your view in respect of this matter as per SA 520. The explanation of the audit team was correct. After doing substantive testing, which also resulted in audit adjustment, there was no need to perform final analytical procedures. Okay. The suggestion of the CFO should have been considered by the audit partner as the CFO was observing the work of the engagement team and hence he could assess that better than the audit partner. No. Right. The requirement in view of the audit partner was valid. The conclusions drawn from the results of the final analytical procedures are intended to corroborate conclusions formed during the audit of individual components or elements of the financial statement. Okay. And the audit team did the right thing by not performing final analytical procedures. However, one additional procedure in that case should have been obtained the document containing the analysis performed by the client on the financial statement. This document is required to be assembled in the audit file. You know, creating the wrong answers requires more creativity than writing the right answer. Okay. So, you know, these point number A, B and D, that is more creative than the correct answer, which is point number C. Okay, because what does it say? No need to perform final analytical procedures. No, the suggestion of the CFO should be right. He could assess better than the audit partner. No. Right, then the last point, what does it say? Did not perform, and he can obtain the analysis performed by the client on the financial statements. No. Right, so what is the correct answer over here? C is the correct answer. The requirement in view of the audit partner was valid. The conclusions drawn from the result of the final analytical procedures are intended to corroborate conclusions formed during the audit of the individual components or the elements of the financial statements. Is it clear to everyone? Next one, question number 4. BDJ Private Limited was established in 2001, and since then the company's operations have grown significantly. The company is based in Kanpur and has branch offices outside Kanpur. The company is engaged in tours and travel business, and because of the nature of the business, it has voluminous transaction. Pay attention. The annual turnover of the company is INR 700 crore. During the audit of the financial statements of the company for 2019, the auditor observed wide variations in various details of sales and various expenses as compared to the last year. Various balances of trade receivable, loan and advances, statutory liability showed significant increase, and many balances were found to be non-moving which were aged for more than 3 years. On the basis of the materiality and the planned procedures, the audit team requested the client for testing of various samples for sales expenses, etc. The audit team requested the client. The client observed that the number of samples that the team has requested increased as compared to last year, and asked the team to cut down on the number of samples so that it is the same number of samples which were tested in the previous year. And they are telling you to reduce the sample size, keep it same as it was last year. The audit team did not agree with this and explained various factors which the team had considered for sample selection and the reasons for changes in the sample, and also explained the requirements of SA 530 to the client, but the client still did not agree. Right, now there is a situation of deadlock, and you are requested to provide your guidance to resolve this matter. The argument of the client is not valid. Sample selection is based on certain principles as per SA 530, and that is on the assessment of the audit team. It may change year on year, and hence the client should provide the required information to the audit team. Okay. The explanation of the audit team is not valid. Referring SA 530 was not correct in this case. This point is not correct in this case. How can you say audit sampling and referring 530? But you know, you should not conclude that immediately. You can also read all the four. The audit team should have explained the entire approach around audit risk assessment to the client before starting the field work, and should have formally shared that with the client in writing. In the given situation, next one, the audit team, instead of getting into an argument, should cut down the number of samples and should increase their procedures around analytical work that would resolve the problem. No. That would not work. The audit team should make a formal request in writing for these details from the client, and if the client still refuses, then they should report this matter to the audit partner. In that case, the auditing standards require that audit partner to check some of the documents which may not be provided by the client to the audit team. You are going to tell boss they are not giving it to us, please you go and check. That's not going to be possible. Right. Yes, pay attention. Are you all watching the video till now? Wonderful. Right. The argument of the client is not valid. Sample selection is based on certain principles as per SA 530, and that is on the assessment of the audit team. It may change year on year, and hence the client should provide the required information to the audit team. Good, everyone. Right. Question number 5. SKJ Private Limited is engaged in the business of construction. The company has also got some real estate project few years back on which it started the work in the last 2 years. Right, so mining business, tours and travels, now they are talking about construction business. Right, the company also got some real estate project few years back on which it started its work in the last 2 years. The annual turnover of the company is 600 crore and profit of INR 40 crore. The statutory auditors of the company got rotated by another audit firm due to mandatory audit rotation requirement as per Companies Act 2013. The new statutory auditors of the company started audit of the financial statements for 2019 in May 2019. So they create a full story. The audit team also requested the client to provide certain information on the opening balances to perform their audit procedure, because it is an initial audit engagement, rotation done. Initially, the management did not provide any information to the auditors on the opening balances, thinking that this is not within the scope of their work. However, after going through the auditing standard, SA510, no, the management agreed and provided the required information. Later on, the audit team also started requesting information for the period from 1st April to 31st May. With this requirement, the CFO of the company got very upset and angry and set up a meeting with the senior members of the audit team. Now he is asking for subsequent events. First, what he said, I didn't do audit for last year, give me that information, initial audit engagement. Now he is wanting further. Right. CFO raised a concern that the audit team has not been doing the work properly and has been asking for unnecessary information, like information on opening balances and then the information for the period after 31st March 2019. What a wonderful combination created in the question. And okay, before the audit and after the audit. Before the audit, when it is initial audit engagement, and if not initial audit engagement, anyways, as per 710, we check for comparative information. And then after the audit, that is 560, subsequent events, right? Okay. The audit partner explained to the CFO that everything requested by the audit team has been as per the auditing standards. However, CFO said that in the earlier year, the previous auditors never asked for such information. Probably the previous auditor had not done a class for audit. Okay, right, you are requested to give your view in respect of this matter. The requirement of the auditor for the opening balances was valid but for the current period 2019 is completely wrong, as that is out of their scope of the current year audit. They can ask for details during the audit of next year. Okay. The concern of the CFO was valid. He has seen the previous auditors not performing such audit procedures, and hence the new audit team should also follow the same approach which was followed by the previous auditor, as that would lead to efficiency in the audit. The audit team should set up a meeting with the previous auditor. My God, look at the vague ideas. This is what you do in your case studies also. You write some man ki baat. And whatever you think, go and talk to this fellow, go and talk to that fellow. Apart from the technical part, what is told on the standard, there are no reference at all. Sab apne man ke hisab se likh ke aate ho. Okay. Right, everything you write as per your mind and you come back. Right? Why you write as per your mind? Because you didn't prepare. No, right now you're just, you know, not utilizing your time properly. No, you say, ma'am, I am studying 16 hours a day. Okay, wonderful. Then though you are like my favorite student. Those who studied 14 hours plus, you know, every day. Amazing students. Right, the audit team should set up a meeting with the previous auditor wherein it should be assessed why different approach was it followed by the previous auditor. On the basis of that discussion with the previous auditor, next course of action should be decided. Okay, the requirement of the auditor for the opening balances as well as for the period after 31st March 2019 is valid. After the requirements of 510 and 560, audit team is required to perform these procedures. Right, so which is the correct option over here? D is the correct option. Right, only opening balances is valid, not right. Concern of the CFO was valid, not valid. Audit team should set up a meeting with the previous auditor. No, don't give us such wrong ideas. Okay, right, so that completes our questions, multiple choice questions from the chapter number 1 as per the ICAI module. Right, so say let's move on now to the MCQs after the chapter number 2. Right, so I assume you are having the soft copy, no problem. You can also have a look at it later. This is chapter number 3, so 2 is over here. Test your knowledge. Audit planning, strategy and execution, multiple choice questions, right? Are you all with me? Okay. AK and company, a firm of chartered accountants, have been operating for the last 6 years, right? Question number 1. Due to the quality of service offered by the firm, it has made its name and is quite renowned, especially in southern India, where its head office is located. The firm has a staff size of 240, including graduates, chartered accountants, management consultants, company secretaries and lawyers. The firm has 3 branches other than the head office at Bangalore, Chennai and Pune. The firm has got many clients for statutory audit over the period and ensures that to maintain the quality of work, proper planning is done by each team before starting any engagement. One of the engagement team picked up for statutory audit for Ofsan Private Limited was involved in the process of planning of audit for 2019. The audit for the financial year 2018 was conducted by a different engagement team. However, the engagement team of Ofsan Private Limited for the current year has got the industry experience. So similar in the industry, they've done the audit. The audit team is confused during the planning work and would like to have your views on the following points. Please advise by answering one of them. Right, so the audit team is confused during the planning work of the audit. The engagement team should consult the previous year's engagement team during the course of their planning. So this year there is a new engagement team. So they have done similar industry but not that client. So it says they should consult the previous year's engagement team. The engagement team should be independent and hence cannot consult the previous year's engagement team during the course of their planning. Why? It is within the firm only, no? So last year, whosoever team, you know, your articles, you are there in office, right? So last year, your friend went for Jio Limited, you went for Mio Limited. Now this year, there is swap. You are going for Jio and friend going for Mio, right? Opposite now. So now, will you not share your experiences with each other? Right, so within the team, will that be allowed? Okay, right, so engagement team should be independent and cannot consult the previous year engagement team. No, they can consult, it's within the firm only. Engagement team needs to maintain confidentiality and hence cannot consult the previous year engagement team during the course of their planning. What confidentiality within the firm? We are not telling it outside. Okay, only the partner who is going to sign the audit report may consult the previous year's audit team. Dare if anybody else talks. No. See, they have to create the options. Okay, right. So the engagement team should consult the previous year's engagement team during the course of their planning. Right. So your friend went for Jio Limited, you went for Mio Limited. This year you're going to go for Jio Limited and friend is going to go for Mio Limited. Can you talk to each other? Right? Can you ask them, how did you do the audit? Can you guide me regarding the planning? And so, yes, 100% yes. So the engagement team should consult the previous year engagement team during the course of their planning. Okay, right, question number 2. Shiteej Private Limited is a company based out of Kochi having operations mainly in Europe. Because of the nature of operations of the company, it is required to prepare its financial statements as per the international standards for reporting to the local regulatory authorities in Europe. Since the business is based in Europe, the audit team is also required to visit the locations wherever the company has offices. Also, you get an opportunity to go there and is accordingly required to perform certain audit procedures. Yes, are you all listening to me? Wonderful. Right, so straight. During the audit of this company for the financial year 2019, the auditors who had planned their work appropriately and had a large team for conducting the audit were facing lot of challenges at various stages. They were also required to revisit their materiality level during the course of the work. However, at the time of the final review, right, when this was discussed with the audit partner, audit in charge, he was not convinced with the approach of the audit team wherein they had reassessed their plans continuously resulting in wastage of time. Right, so revision of audit plan, revision of audit strategy, he was not convinced. It says you're just wasting time. Right, in this situation, please advise which one of the following would be correct. Audit partner being the senior most team member is right and the same thing should be considered by the audit team by documenting it in the audit file. Okay. Then audit partner's view is not correct as the audit team did the right thing. Right. Audit partner was correct. However, during the course of an audit which requires visit at various locations, it was mandatory. Audit partner's view is not correct because the materiality was revised by the audit team, which is a big thing, and the same should have been considered by the audit partner. Right? So audit partner's view is not correct because the materiality was revised by audit team, which is a big thing, and the same should have been considered by the audit partner. Okay, audit partner being the senior most is always right. So what is the audit partner telling over here? He was not convinced with the approach. No, so audit partner view is right, not right. Right, so audit partner view is not correct as the audit team did the right thing. They kept on reassessing materiality as and when they came to know new things. Audit partner was correct. However, during the course of audit visit at various locations which required it was mandatory, not because it is for a visit of various location. Audit partner view is not correct. Now, this is also not correct. This is also not correct. Right, because the materiality was revised by the audit team, which is a big thing, and the same should have been considered by the audit partner. No, any member of the audit team, they can revise the materiality and document the reasons for the same. Right. So which is the correct answer over here? The audit partner's view is not correct, as the audit team did the right thing, right? They reassessed materiality as and when required. Right, coming to question number 3. RJ Private Limited, having its office at Bangalore and operations across southern India, had a discussion with its statutory auditors regarding the audit plan and the timelines. In the past years, there has been significant delays in completion of audit work, and the management wanted that for the current year, audit should get completed on time. For doing this, the audit team suggested that the information for the purpose of the audit should be ready on time, and only then the timelines as agreed can be achieved. On the basis of the discussion, so see, your theory part of the writing of the paper will improve when you've read so much. On the basis of the discussions with the clients, the auditors, and the internal discussions amongst the audit team members, a detailed audit program was prepared by the audit team for the current year audit. But the audit team discussed that they will not document this audit program till the completion of the audit work, because at various stages the work requires changes. So now what is the problem? They will not document the audit program. That is what they are contemplating. Right, because it requires changes. If the audit team documents the audit program, then it would create problems later on at the time of assembly of the audit file, wherein the audit team would have to show the changes made by them in the audit program during the course of the audit. You are required to share your views in respect of this understanding and approach of the auditor. Okay. The decision of audit team regarding not documenting the audit program is very good. No, very bad. As this would avoid unnecessarily problems of documentation of changes made in the audit program at the time of assembly of file. Not at all good. Are you getting that? Okay. Instead of considering the audit program, the audit team could have prepared a checklist. In case of a checklist, such problem will not arise. Because in case of a checklist, if any changes are made, then the final checklist can be kept in the file along with the old working checklist used during the audit. So he says, don't prepare program, prepare checklist. What idea they give us, huh? Okay, the approach of the audit team not to document audit program is not correct. The audit team needs to document it properly at the time of planning stage itself, and any changes made after that should also be documented with the explanations. Okay. Right, the decision of the audit team not to document the audit program is not correct. Okay, they are concerned that the changes may arise in the audit program is valid. However, to take care of that, the audit team can take approval from the ICAI. You know why ICAI has come into picture? Later on, when those changes will be made. So whenever you need to make a change in your audit program, you have to take consultation from ICAI. Okay, the audit team will have to document the changes and the approval note of the ICAI. It's like a safed jute and a white line. Ye kya bol rahe ho aap? And why take consultation of ICAI or approval of ICAI when you need to make a change in your audit program? No. Right, so that is C is the correct option. Coming to question number 4. KJ Private Limited has a business of pharmaceuticals and has an annual turnover of INR 1500 crore. During the last few years, considering the environment in which the company operates, its profits have reduced and are still reducing. But right now, pharmaceuticals are having a gala time. Okay, they are having a great time. All, you know, PhD funds, mutual fund, all the pharmaceutical companies, share prices, mutual fund, all going up. Right, considering the environment, its profits have reduced and are still reducing. Hence, the management has been looking at various ways to cut the cost. AD and associates are the statutory auditors of the company, and RM and associates are the internal auditors of the company. Initially, the company did not want to appoint any internal auditors to save cost. However, at the insistence of the statutory auditors, the company appointed the internal auditors. During the course of the statutory audit for 2019, the statutory auditors requested for the detailed working papers of the internal auditor. So they are asking for the detailed working papers of the internal auditor, which the internal auditor refused. However, the statutory auditors told the management if the same are not provided, then they would qualify their report. Right? So statutory auditor only insisted, no, you appoint internal auditor. And now they are telling that internal auditor ka working paper I want. Okay, in this situation, please advise which of the following would be correct. The statutory auditor should review the detailed working papers, but they cannot qualify their report on this ground. The statutory auditors may review the detailed working papers, and even after that, they may qualify their report. The statutory auditors are not required to go to the extent of review of detailed working papers of internal auditor, and the statutory auditors may review the detailed working papers of the internal auditors, but for that purpose they would require the approval of ICAI. Wonderful, we delete that one. Now, the statutory auditor should review the detailed working paper, may review the detailed working paper. No, statutory auditor, you have no right to review the working papers of the internal auditor. Okay, so the statutory auditors are not required to go to the extent of review of the detailed working papers of the internal auditors, right? So C is the correct option, right? Not required to go to the extent of the detailed review, any review, require extent of the review of the detailed working papers of the internal auditors. Right, coming to the fifth one over there. Everybody, are you paying attention? Yes? Oh, you're saying up to yesterday it was live. Now today there is no chat happening. Okay, nobody putting any comment or no ABCD coming over there. You know, that's the only constant in life, change. Hannah, did you ever imagine, you know, that at this point of time you will be in the lockdown, 40 plus days, you're not going away from home. Had you anticipated that this will be the situation of your life 1 year down the line? Like, you know, say last year, May 2019, okay, had you thought this is going to be the position in May 2020? Was even the sea of corona there around that time? No. So change is the only constant. So having a block, that live was better, now here ma'am, today MCQ, no. That block is a big problem. Change is the only constant. The more you accept the change, the more like a river you are free flowing, the more it goes better for you in life. Those who've heard the lecture so far, that is good. They are able to hear, listen this and probably understand and change their view. Those who've already closed down the video and again, you know, say, "Acha, theek hai, today aaj live nahi hai, chalo, fir aaj I will also not be live. I will also sleep for some more time." Should not happen so. Okay. Right, see, I have very big concern, you know, regarding you studying well, you being motivated, you being in the right frame of mind for doing study, in the right mental and physical condition for doing your studies. Right, very important, okay. If the food comes out good, only when the ingredients which go and the skills which go into the making of the food are good. Right, see, your results, your success, all will be good if all what goes into the making of it is also good. Okay, right, so pay attention, huh? Theek hai. RIM Private Limited is engaged in the business of manufacturing of steel having annual turnover of 10,000 crore. So all types of industries we are seeing. Steel, pharmaceutical, tools and travel, mining and real estate and all. Okay, right, the company has a very capital intensive and has its plants at two locations, Mohali and Hosur. During 2019, the company carried out a detailed physical verification of its property, plant and equipment and also reassessed their useful lives by engaging a consultant. The consultant submitted its report to the management on 21st of April. The statutory auditors of the company started their audit work from May 19, and when this information was given to them regarding the physical verification and the reassessment of the useful lives of property, plant and equipment, the auditors told the management that the consultant should have submitted its report to the auditors also independently. Right? The auditor told the management that the consultant should have submitted its report to the auditors also independently. This auditor also has some high demand he'll make. Further, in the absence of this direct communication of the report of the consultant to the auditor, the audit team would have to review the work of the consultant, which is not sufficient but cannot be avoided now. Management did not agree with the points of the auditor that the consultant should have shared the report with the auditor directly and that the auditor needs to review the work of the consultant. The management would like to have your views on this matter. The view of the management seems to be correct because there is no such requirement that any consultant of the company should share his report directly to the auditor. Also, when the consultant has already submitted a detailed report, no further review is required on that. Now, second part is not right. Not giving the report directly to the auditor, fine, but he will not review the report, that is not right. Okay, so plus, minus, minus, no. Okay, both the management and the auditors are not correct. Auditor is not supposed to receive the report directly. Furthermore, the auditor needs to review the work of the consultant irrespective of the fact whether he has received the report directly or not. Seems to be a sensible point. But let us look into the other two. Right? So A is to anyways not there.
Right, see, the auditor's requirements are reasonable because he carries duty in respect of the audit of the financial statements. And by not getting report directly from the consultant, he would not know whether it belongs to that consultant or not. And now only because of this lack of proper communication, the auditor would have to review the work of the consultant. Oh no, what story? If I don't receive the report directly, I don't know which consultant has issued the report. Both management and auditor should find a solution to this problem. The management may request the consultant to send the report to the auditor directly now. On the basis of the same, the auditor can avoid unnecessary procedure related to review of report of the consultant. No. Tell him that okay, give the report. No, and then he need not review. No, that option is also not viable. Right, so what is the correct option over here? B. Both the management and the auditors are not correct. The auditor is not supposed to receive the report directly. Further, the auditor needs to review the work of the consultant irrespective of the fact whether he received the report directly or not. Okay. Wonderful. Right, so that completes our MCQ for the chapter number 2. Right, as per the ICAI module. Right, so now let's come to the next chapter, that is the risk assessment and the internal control. Right, let's come to the next chapter, risk assessment and internal control as per the ICAI module. Right, risk assessment and the internal control. Right, Raj Private Limited is engaged in the business of retail and is having retail outlets concentrated towards Northern India. So now retail business. Currently, the company has 59 outlets and the plan of the management is to take this to at least 100 over the next 2 years. The company is audited by Raj & Associates, a firm of chartered accountants who have been operating for over 20 years. However, they don't have much experience in the retail sector. Because of this fact, the audit team decided to plan efficiently for the audit of the financial statements for 2019, being their first year for audit. Right? Paying attention? Okay, during the course of risk assessment by the auditors, it was discussed that the company is operating in an industry where the operations are not very complicated and mostly the processes are known to all. Considering the same, they decided that the assessment of inherent risk should not be done for this company as that would be inefficient. Oh, now we get the crux. That assessment of inherent risk should not be done for this company as that would be inefficient. However, the auditors will take due care of the control risk. The same assessment was deliberated upon and after a lot of discussion, it was finalized like this. In the given situation, please advise which one of the following would be correct. Assessment of audit team is correct. No problem. Don't assess inherent risk. Directly assess control risk only. The assessment of audit team is wrong considering the fact that it is a private company wherein such assessment is not possible. So it says because it is private company, it is right. Okay, such assessment will not be possible. The assessment of audit team is wrong for this company. The assessment of audit team is correct considering the fact that this has been thoroughly discussed. Okay, right. So wrong, correct, correct. Right, so what does it say? Assessment of audit team is correct. And last one, the assessment of audit team is correct considering the fact that this has been thoroughly discussed. These 2 points out. Now B and C. The assessment of the audit team is wrong considering the fact that it is a private company. Now that is not a reason that it's a private company. Right, so what is the correct option over here? C. The assessment of the audit team is wrong for this company. It cannot happen that you don't assess the inherent risk and you directly go for the assessment of the control risk. Okay. Right, question number 2. Right, what is that? Kshitij Private Limited is a company based out of Noida having operations in India and Dubai. The company's operations in Dubai have increased over the last 2 years and the management is earning very good profits. Because of the profits, the management also planned that they should now focus on strengthening of internal controls of the company. And for that purpose, they have discussed with the statutory auditors to carry out the audit for 2019 very rigorously. The report on internal financial controls is also applicable to the company and hence the auditors during the course of their work asked for risk control matrices from the company. During 2018, risk control matrix was not available with the company and was prepared in a draft manner and the same was shared with the audit team during that year and the auditors completed their work on the basis of that. However, for the year 2019, the auditors would like to have a robust documentation and are not ready to accept the same risk control matrices. In the given situation, please suggest what should be the course of action. right, report on IFC is applicable, and hence auditors have asked their, yes, during the course of their work have asked for risk control matrices. Risk control matrices was not available and was prepared in a draft manner, and the same was shared with the audit team. Right, in the given situation, please suggest what should be the course of action. The request of the audit team is correct and the management should provide that. The requirement of the audit team is not justified considering the fact that last year same documentation was used by them. The requirement of audit team is not justified considering the fact that it's a private company and auditor anyways is required to perform rigorous audit procedures. In the case of a private company on which IFC report is required, the auditor is not allowed to take any risk control metrics from the management seems to be an ethical issue. Okay, so requirement of audit team is not justified, so it seems to be an ethical issue. These three points for us are not justified. Requirement of audit team not justified, audit team not justified, it seems to be an ethical issue. What is the ethical issue over there? Right, so simple, direct, clear understanding. The request of the audit team is correct and the management should provide that. Right, the request of the audit team is correct and the management should provide that. Okay, next one. Question number 3, SK Private Limited. Yes, are you all paying attention? Right, SK Private Limited is a medium-sized company having operations in Jharkhand. The company manufactures some parts and sells that to various dealers on the ex-work basis. Okay, right, the financial statements of the company are prepared as per Ind AS and the internal financial control report is also applicable on the same. Right, SK Private Limited is a medium-sized company. It manufactures parts and Ind AS and IFC applicable. During the course of the audit for 2019, the management of the company had a detailed discussion with the auditors for audit planning. Further, it was also decided that any observations of the auditors should also be discussed with the management before conclusion by the audit team, which was not done in the past years. Considering this, the auditors started the risk assessment and requested the management to share their documentation for the same, on which the management said that they don't have any risk and if the auditors come across any such thing, they can discuss that matter with the management. Right? The auditors started risk assessment and requested management, okay, have you done any risk assessment from your side? Risk components of internal control, CRISM, right? Our risk assessment. They say, we've not identified any risk. If you come across anything, you please let me know. Right, but the auditors were not convinced with the view of the management, and the same thing has happened in the past years as well. You're required to provide your inputs to resolve this matter. The requirement of the audit team is not correct. The view of the management is correct because of the applicability of Ind AS. The view of the management is correct because of the applicability of internal financial control reporting, and the view of the management is not correct. Right, so requirement of audit team is not correct. No, very much we are going to ask the management for the risk assessment. So this is not a correct answer option. Right, requirement of audit team is not correct. Okay, then management is correct because of Ind AS. Management is correct because of IFC. Just making lame excuses. Okay, right, so what is the correct option over here? The view of the management is not correct. They have to give the information to the auditor. They have to do the risk assessment. Right, question number 4. AJ Private Limited is in the business of telecom and having significant operations across India, predominantly in northern India. The statutory auditors of the company have been continuing for the past 3 years and have been issuing a clean report. Right, for the financial year 2019, the statutory auditors commenced their work in 2019 as per the discussions with the management with the plan to complete the work by first week of May 2019. The audit team concluded the work as per the agreed timelines and the financial statements and audit report were signed on the 5th of May along with the engagement letter for 2019. In the given situation, please advise which of the following would be correct. Engagement letter should have been signed before commencing the audit work. Engagement letter should have been signed at least a day before the signing the audit report. Engagement letter should have been signed at least a day before signing the financial statements. Engagement letter is optional in case of a private company and hence it can be signed any time. Wonderful. Okay, any time out. At least a day before signing the report, at least a day before signing the financial statements, out. Right, so what is the correct option over here? A. Right, the engagement letter should have been signed before commencing the audit work. right? The engagement letter should have been signed before commencing the audit work. Okay. Right. Question number 5. Rin Private Limited is engaged in the business of manufacturing of water bottles. Okay. And is experiencing significant increase in turnover year on year. It is a subsidiary of Rin GmbH based out of Germany. During the financial year 2019, the company carried out a detailed physical verification of its inventory and property, plant and equipment. During the year, various other activities were carried out to increase efficiency in operations and reduction of cost. The statutory auditors of the company started their work from April 2019 and requested for a documentation on changes in processes and activities during the year, as well as any resultant impact of the same on the management controls. The management of the company told the auditors that all such documentation is maintained by the parent company, as this is a closely held private company, and even though internal financial control reporting is applicable on this company, the parent company is taking due care of each and every process. Right. The auditors did not agree with the views of the management. Please advise both the management and the auditors. The auditor should look for documentations as the Sarbanes-Oxley Act, because the holding company is outside India. Okay. The auditors are correct in this case, and the management should provide the required documentation. The auditors are correct in this case and the management should provide the required documentation. However, in case the parent company is covered by Sarbanes-Oxley, then it can be ignored by the auditor and the management is correct. I told the auditor that this documentation is maintained by parent company. So management is correct? No, management is not correct. Auditor should look for documentations as per Sarbanes-Oxley in this case? No, IFC applicable, Sarbanes-Oxley separate, IFC separate. Right, then it should be ignored if Sarbanes-Oxley is there, parent company is covered by Sarbanes-Oxley? No. Right, so B, the auditors are correct in this case, and hence the management should provide the required documentation. Right, the auditors are correct in this case and the management should provide the required documentation. Right, so that completes our MCQ for the chapter number 3. Right, that completes our MCQ for the chapter number 3. Right, one more for today. Let us look into the MCQ for chapter number 4. Right, what is chapter number 4? The special aspects of auditing in the automated environment as per the ICAI module. Right, so coming to chapter number 4. Right, KPL Private Limited. Right, so have you opened the ICAI module, or if you are looking at it over here also, no problem. Right, so now coming to the MCQs for chapter number 4. KPL Private Limited is a large software company based out of Hyderabad. The annual turnover of the company is INR 2100 crore. The company sells software and is also involved in the implementation of those software for its clients. The major chunk of revenue though comes from the sale of software only. So they also do implementation, but main business is what? Sells software. The company works on a completely paperless office, and accordingly most of the documents are available in the soft copy. During 2019, the auditors during the course of their audit obtained various audit evidences. Some of these were in hard, but mostly in the soft copy. On the conclusion of the audit, the auditors are in a dilemma whether to maintain their documentation entirely in hard copy or in soft copy, or it can be a mix of both. After consultations with various persons, the auditor stood that the documentation for this company being operating in a fully automated environment should be in the soft copy only. Please advise whether this understanding is correct. This is a matter of documentation. So it is 230 plus automated environment coming together. This is a matter of documentation of audit evidence for a client working in a fully automated environment, and hence it should be in a soft copy only. As per the requirement of the auditing standard, this documentation can be a mix of both soft and hard copy. Since the client is operating in a fully automated environment, it would be important to check with them, because all this documentation has come from the client only. As per the requirements of the auditing standard, documentation is not required in case of a client working in an automated environment, because everything is automated and can be accessed easily at any point of time. Safed jhoot, white lie. Documentation is not required.
This is a matter of documentation of audit evidence for a client working in a fully automated environment, and hence it should be in soft copy only, no only.
Right, since the client, as per the requirement of auditing standard, it can be a mix of both soft and hard copy, okay? And since the client is operating in a fully automated environment, it would be important to check with them, because all this documentation has come from the client only. So nothing to be checked with them. You can maintain a combination of the soft and hard copy. Right, you can maintain a combination of the soft and hard copy. Right, coming to question number 2.
KJ Private Limited is engaged in the business of e-commerce, wherein most of the operations are automated. Right, the company has SAP as its ERP package and is planning to upgrade the SAP version. Currently, the version of SAP being used is fine, but the higher version would lead to increased efficiencies, and hence the company is considering this plan, which will also involve a huge outlay. KPP and Associates were appointed as the statutory auditors of this company for 2019, and the statutory audit firm has been working in this industry for long, but most of the work which the firm did was more of risk advisory or internal audit. For the first time, this audit will be conducted, and that's why the audit team started obtaining understanding of the operations of the company, which include understanding of the SAP system of the company. However, the management of the company was not comfortable with this approach of the audit team, particularly because audit team was spending good time on understanding of the IT systems of the company. The management suggested the auditor should limit their understanding and should perform audit procedures rather than getting into business and operation. But the auditors have a different view on this matter, and because of this, the work has got stuck. In the given situation, please advise what should be the course of action. Okay, the approach of the audit team to obtain detailed understanding of the company before starting with the audit procedures is absolutely fine. If the auditors don't understand the systems properly, the audit procedures may not be appropriate. Okay. The management's concern regarding the approach of the auditor seems reasonable. The auditors are spending time on understanding of the system, businesses, and not performing their audit procedures. No, the auditor has to spend time on understanding the system and processes. They are not wasting time. Okay, this being a private company, there is some soft corner. No, why you didn't study today? No, I'm not feeling little well. So soft corner. This being a private company, and that too in the business of e-commerce, the also second reason, private company, e-commerce, the auditor should have knowledge about the operations of the company through their understanding of the industry, and hence should not get into the process of obtaining the detailed information at the client place. Not done. The audit team could have planned their work differently. They should involve IT experts who would have knowledge of the systems of the company, and lot of time can be saved. Further, in case of such type of industry, involvement of IT experts is anyways required mandatorily as per the legal requirement. You know, it feels like, okay, you found me only since morning to tell all this story. Okay, right, so the approach of the audit team to obtain detailed understanding of the company before starting with the audit procedures is absolutely fine. If the auditors don't understand the systems properly, the audit procedures may not be appropriate. Okay, right, coming to third one. Right, AR Private Limited is a medium-sized company engaged in the business of trading of electronic equipment. The company has various warehouses where all of these equipments are kept and has inventory levels of generally 2 to 3 months. The internal environment of the company is driven by various processes. Some of them are manual and some automated. Accordingly, the management has also set up various controls, both manual and automated, and is comfortable with their design and operating effectiveness. Okay, so some manual control, some automated control. During the course of the audit for 2019, the auditors raised various queries regarding various processes where the controls were operating effectively. This was because of the fact that auditor was considering either manual controls or only automated controls in a process. Earlier, first question, what he was stuck, either soft copy or hard copy, not both. Now what he's saying, either manual control or automated control, not both. Okay, very rigid auditor.
हाँ, as per the auditor, the management should have adopted the same approach and hence it would like to increase the substantive audit procedures because they had a view that as per the current approach of the management, control should be considered as ineffective irrespective of the fact that testing which the audit team had performed resulted in the controls being effective. And you consider our controls to be ineffectively and accordingly auditor you do the audit. That is what the current approach of the management. Currently, the concern falls regarding the approach on which the management was also stuck on their point. You are required to provide your inputs to resolve this matter. The approach of the management doesn't seem to be correct because of the nature of operations of the company. The current approach which the management has followed can be accepted only in case of a manufacturing industry, a bukis and a bali ka bakra, now who they have made the responsible thing for over here because of manufacturing industry. Okay. Right, they who they made as the culprit, you know, over here. It's because manufacturing industry. The management should have discussed their approach with the auditors before appointing them. The Companies Act 2013 provides specific guidance on these matters, wherein the management of the company can follow such approach by taking pre-approval from the auditors, and in such a case, the report of the auditor is always clean, or compulsory once you've taken the pre-approval from the auditor. The approach of the management is completely fine. The auditors need to correct their understanding of the internal control and the application of internal control. A process cannot be limited to have either only manual control or automated control. Okay. Right. Considering the size of the company, such matters should be ignored by the auditor. Even if the approach of the management is not correct, it would not have any impact on the work of the auditors because all such matters get resolved at the time when the auditor performs final analytical procedures. So now who is the standby? When you do analytical, then this matter will be sorted. There is no link in that. Okay, then another B point, the Companies Act 2013 provides guidance wherein management of the company can follow such approach by taking pre-approval from the auditor. I am not aware of any such section in the company law. Right. So the correct option over here is C. The approach of the management is completely fine. The auditors need to correct their understanding of internal controls and the application of the internal control. A process cannot be limited to have either only the manual controls or the automated control. Okay, right. Coming to question number 4. AJ Private Limited is engaged is in the business of construction and infrastructure and having an annual turnover of 1100 crore. The operations of the company are run efficiently driven by the well laid out policies and procedures. The processes of the company are very strong and are very well documented and properly communicated to its employees as required. The management has also done a detailed risk assessment in the earlier year and currently the risk management system of the company is considered to be very effective. The internal controls include both automated and manual. Okay. During the course of the audit of the financial statements of the company for 2019, the statutory auditors did their risk assessment and also reviewed the general IT controls which were found to be effective. Considering the same, one of the senior audit team members asked the team to start performing the substantive audit procedures, taking the approach that controls are effective. So they've only checked general IT controls. They've not yet checked the application controls. However, the audit team did not find this approach correct and discussed that they should also check the effectiveness of other manual and automated control by testing them and then move on to the substantive testing. Okay, one of the senior team members said that, but the audit team is saying that this approach is not correct. The audit team recently had a training on the internal controls and hence their understanding was different from the audit senior. This led to a conflicting situation between the audit senior and the remaining audit team. In the given situation, please advise which of the following would be correct. The audit senior is correct because general IT controls were found to be effective and hence no further work may be required on the control. Okay. The view of the audit team looks fine because testing of internal controls covering all types of control, manual and automated, those controls without testing cannot be said to be operating effectively. Okay, the audit senior seems reasonable in this approach because general IT controls were found to be effective. However, it would be more appropriate to also test application control before concluding on the effectiveness of the control. the argument of the audit team looks better because every audit requires significant time to be spent on testing of internal control, and by only covering the general IT controls, it would be difficult to justify this requirement later on in the audit file. So they are only concerned about the audit file over here. Right. So the audit senior is correct. The audit senior seems reasonable. These points we need to delete. The view of the audit team looks fine because without testing of internal control, covering all types of control, manual and automated, those controls cannot be said to be operating effectively. And last one, they are concerned about the audit file, not right. Right. So B is the correct option. Right. Those controls cannot be said to be operating effectively. Right. The next one over here, fifth one. Right, RIM Private Limited is engaged in the business of manufacturing of cranes and other construction equipment. The nature of operations are such that purchases are quite significant, even though the sales may or may not be significant in terms of number of transactions during the year. Right, the company statutory auditors have also obtained certain audit tools to help the audit team on various audit procedures to bring efficiency in various audits. During the course of the audit for 2019, the auditors used those audit tools, also known as the computer-assisted audit techniques, for sampling procedures and data analytics. The outcome of the tools resulted in some analysis and requirement which the audit team requested from the client. However, the client refused to provide any such information because, as per the client, all these tools were those of the auditor and any outcome of those same needs to be handled by themselves instead of asking the management. The auditors have suggested that such an attitude of non-cooperation would not help either the party and would defeat the objective of the audit. The management of the company is, however, ready to provide any other information to the auditors. Right? So what they are saying? Right? Not the client refused to provide any information. The outcome of the tools resulted in some analysis and requirements which the audit team requested from the client, and client is not ready to provide the information. In this situation, please advise both the management and the auditors. Right? Since the management is ready to provide any other information, the auditor should obtain this information as well by not disclosing the management that it is the outcome of an audit tool. So tell them, ye wo nahi hai, ye wo other information hai. Okay. The view of the management is correct because audit tools are there to support the auditors and not to increase the work of the management. Oh my God. Right? The auditors are correct because by using audit tools, they are performing their audit procedures. The auditor should ignore all these tools and plan their audit procedures accordingly. How can you ignore computer-assisted audit techniques? No. Management is ready to provide, so you tell them that it is the outcome of not disclosing that it is the outcome of any tool? No. View of management is correct because audit tools are there to support the auditor and not to lead to increase work for the management, not right. Right, so the auditors are correct because by using the audit tools, they are performing their audit procedures, and straightforward, clear-cut options are generally the right ones, right, rather than those which are beating around the bush. Right, so the auditors are correct because by using the audit tools, they are performing their audit procedures. Right, so we've seen the MCQs for the first four chapters today. Right, certainly it is going to add to your level of preparation for the exams and also for your confidence in solving the MCQs in the exam. Right, so I thank you very much.